So here we are on video number 6, and to be honest with you, this one was a bear to shoot. As I've said in the past, the shop is not particularly video friendly, and there's a lot of content to be edited. And since it's really not meant to be an instructional video either, but one that just shows some of the process, the decision of what to leave in, what to take out, is sometimes a bit difficult. I tried to leave in just enough to show the process and keep it interesting without it being too boring. So it might be a bit long. I'm still learning as I go to figure out what's the proper length to have an interesting video. So have a look, comment if you're so inclined, and here we go. The video doesn't always do what you want it to do, but this is simply some sandpaper on the edge of a straight edge. I don't really need a shooting board for this. This is a nice flat surface, and I'm lifting it simply by putting it on the piece below it. That raises it up enough to give me a straight. And then we'll take a look against the window. The piece all around, that's perfectly joined. That looks great. And I have this call here, which has a slight arc so that I can put pressure on the center as well as the edges. Okay, that's going to lock it down, and while this is happening, I can get on with a reef red job. Okay, time to take this out. Okay, let's see if we can throw the back in here, and we'll get ready to cut these guys out. Okay, let's join this back. Okay, we're going to get started on the back bracing. I have the four back braces fairly dimensioned for the thickness. And what I'm going to do here is to radius them in the bracing radius jig that I just whipped up for myself for this particular project. And I'm going to radius the back at 20 feet. And the way I'm going to do that is to first see what the distance is on this particular brace. It's about 7/16. So on the edges, which I'll take down a little bit on the belt sander. That gives me a bit of a head start on some of the radius. Again, it's not accurate by any means, but now I can set up the jig. I have the ability to keep it in. And as you can see, it fits perfectly in that radius. Now I'll do the other three and the top as well in that same manner. What I thought I would also show is that for those without a belt sander, using my planer. And we get the same tailored edge from the center out to give me a little bit easier task at sanding. Very nice. And very simple. There we go. Let's do a quick layout. Okay, we're getting ready to sand this down to thickness, and I'm going to listen to the board. See what I hear. I love the smell of this torrified wood. And I'm not looking for notes at this particular stage. Actually, I'm not looking for notes at any particular stage, although notes will be produced. It's hard to describe what it is I'm listening for, but some of it is for the complexity of the note, which is, I understand, an ambiguous, personal thing that you hear as a builder. But I'm also looking for the length of the note. I've had some boards that I've made where I've over-braced them or over-scalloped them even, and they have stopped producing a good quality of long note. And that's the best way I can describe it. It's tough to say if you're not here listening to it. But we're getting ready to sand. Okay, that's a little light 320 sanding. Get that off. very nice. Okay. It smells super. Still love to do clamps, plus I don't have any room for a go-bar deck anyway. Okay, looking good, looking good. I'll take a quick listen just to see what we got. Ah, sounds great. Okay, got our basic layout done here, and we'll move on to the back. Okay, let's let that dry. I hate it when I don't have the video light. Spend all the time talking and doing all sorts of stuff that never shows up. So here we go again. Okay. Okay, looking good. Tomorrow's another day. Thank you. this is where the rubber meets the road. Or some of the rubber, anyway. Lays down beautifully.
Thank you.